Voltage series feedback amplifier. This is the module 4 of analog circuit subject. So here there are totally four types of feedback amplifiers. One is voltage series feedback amplifier, voltage shunt feedback amplifier, current series feedback amplifier, and current shunt feedback amplifier. So that depends on which is the parameter that is taken at the input side and what is the way it is taken. If it is the voltage parameter that is taken, that too with the series with the input, it is called as voltage series feedback amplifier. And if it is taken with parallel with the input, then it is voltage shunt feedback amplifier. And in this circuit, I am taking the voltage parameters to the input side. If I am taking the current parameter to the input side, it will be either current series feedback amplifier or it will be current shunt feedback amplifier. Out of those, for the syllabus, there are only two types, that is voltage series feedback amplifier, that is the first circuit, and the other circuit is voltage shunt feedback amplifier, it is there for the syllabus. So today let us start with voltage series feedback amplifier. This is the figure that what you can see, which is designed using an operational amplifier, non-inverting input terminal, inverting input terminal. This is the feedback resistor RF, the load resistor RL, and one more resistance R1, across which the feedback voltage VF is taken. Right? Now, with respect to this circuit diagram, I can write A, beta, and AF, these three parameters. A is nothing but, it is an open loop gain. Open loop gain means, gain is defined as the ratio of output voltage to the input voltage. So, A is nothing but, we have defined it as V0 divided by VID, because the actual output is V0 here. And to this operational amplifier, without considering the feedback, the actual input is VID, that is the differential input voltage between V1 and V2. That's why I can write A equal to V0 divided by VID. Next, coming to the next parameter, AF. F means it is feedback. So AF means it is a voltage gain with feedback. So that case, I need to consider the entire circuit. So again, I can define the gain as it is the ratio of output voltage to the input voltage. So the actual output voltage is V0 only, and the actual input voltage considering the feedback, it will be V, that is applied from this side. So the gain with feedback is defined as V0 divided by V. Another parameter that I can define is beta. Beta is nothing but it's a feedback factor. Again, that's also part of gain only. Again, for this one, I need to consider the ratio of output voltage to the input voltage. But if you consider this feedback circuit, that is this part, I am giving input from this side and taking output from this side. Right? So for this feedback circuit, my input voltage will be V0 and output voltage will be the feedback voltage VF. That's why I can write the feedback factor beta as VF, which is nothing but output, divided by V0, which is my actual input to this feedback circuit. Next, let us go with the negative feedback. What is meant by negative feedback? There are two types of feedback. One is negative feedback, another is positive feedback. It depends on whether the input signal is in phase with the feedback signal or it is out of phase. If the input signal to the operational amplifier, if it is in phase with the output voltage, it is called as positive feedback. And if the input voltage is out of phase with respect to the output voltage, then I will be calling it as negative feedback. So for this negative feedback, what is the input that I have given? If you remember, this operational amplifier can also be called as a differential amplifier. Differential amplifier means it amplifies the difference between the two input voltages. What are the two input voltages that are shown here? One is V1 and another is V2. So the difference of those I will take, which is nothing but V1 minus V2. So this is the differential voltage VID. But here in this circuit, as I have applied input voltage to the non-inverting input terminal, I can write V1 equal to V. And what is the voltage at the pin number 2? It is nothing but the feedback voltage VF. So I can write V2 equal to, I can write it is the feedback voltage VF. Now let us derive an expression for the closed loop voltage gain for this circuit. I can define the AF as, which is already defined here, AF equal to V0 divided by V, that is, it is the ratio of output voltage to the input voltage, right? Now, as we have identified it as a differential amplifier, the output of the differential amplifier, I can write it as, it is the amplified version of difference between the two input voltages. Now, this is the amplification factor, and whatever I have written here, that is nothing but the difference. So output voltage V naught is nothing but the amplified version of the difference between the two input voltages, which is called as differential amplifier. Again, looking back to the circuit, what is V1? V1 is nothing but it is the voltage that is available at the non-inverting input terminal, which is nothing but V, because I have applied input voltage to the non-inverting input terminal, so I can write V1 equal to V. And what is the voltage at the non-inverting terminal? That is V2. The feedback voltage is applied to the non-inverting input terminal, that is Vf. That is the feedback voltage is the voltage that is developed across the resistance R1. So I can write V2 equal to Vf. And how to get how much of voltage is developed across this? This Rf and R1, they constitute the voltage divider bias. So the voltage that is applied here, it produces a current and current flows through this part. So the overall current, I can write it as the overall parameter, that is voltage V0 divided by what is the total resistance in this part? It is R1 plus Rf. So I can write R1 plus Rf. So whatever I have written inside the bracket, that is nothing but the current parameter. Ultimately, I want to Vf. What is Vf? It is the voltage drop across the resistor R1, which is got by multiplying current into this resistor. So this I have written it as current. So if I multiply this with resistance R1, then I will be getting the voltage drop across R1, which is nothing but Vf. So the same is written here, Vf equal to R1 into V0 divided by R1 plus Rf. Now the values of this V1 and V2 I am going to substitute in this equation. So V0 equal to A times, what is V1? It is nothing but V minus V2 is nothing but R1 V0 divided by R1 plus Rf. I can take the LCM and I can write this, and finally, ultimately, I need AF equal to what is AF? The voltage gain with feedback, which is the ratio of output voltage divided by input voltage, and that can be written as A into bracket R1 plus Rf divided by R1 plus Rf plus AR1, right? But we will assume some things, that is AR1 is very greater than R1 plus Rf, because R1 is the input resistance, and I can see that the gain and input resistance of the operational amplifier are very high as compared to the sum of these, that is R1 plus Rf. So by considering this assumption, I can write Af equal to V0 divided by V. That is, from this one I can write that is nothing but R1 divided by R1 plus Rf, where R1 is the resistance across which the feedback is taken.